you can see how these cells move and how embryo develops. This microscope actually won the Nobel Prize 3 years ago. So really big stuff.
I mean, they come into the labs, never seen a pipette or a live cell. In a matter of a few weeks, they're presenting, you know, high-end research and able to speak it, and just jaw-dropping.
When I look at the program across the board, we are changing people's lives. We are changing the way they think about themselves, the way they feel about themselves, the way they envision their futures. For almost a decade, we've been building a pipeline initiative that provides tremendous opportunities for students that come from disadvantaged backgrounds. The very first year, we brought in two students with the idea of just giving them a laboratory job. And over the course of the last 10 years, we've taken that initial idea and now it's become a full umbrella program that we call the Johns Hopkins Initiative for Careers in Science and Medicine. It includes two high school components, which is the Summer Academic Research Experience, or SARE, the Biophysics Research for Baltimore Teens, or BRBT, the undergraduate portions called the Summer Internship Program, and then we have a post-bac portion which we call the Doctoral Diversity Program.
Why cells move, how they move. The epithelium display this ability to migrate.
First off, they're going to have a mentored research experience. And this is where they're working in a laboratory on a research project with their doctoral or postdoctoral fellow mentor. But then there's a huge, very large academic portion. So at the high school level, we have a very well-developed academic curriculum. We push students on their math skills, their reading and writing skills. We talk about ethics, we talk about science, of course. And then the third major component is professionalism. And so that includes all aspects of professionalism. How to look a person in the eye when you're interacting with them. How to show up on time, how to prepare your results and be able to communicate those orally in a very professional scientific presentation, and how to dress for that presentation. It's really fun to watch the scholars come through. They become each other's families while they're here. A really supportive, interactive group that all of a sudden now recognizes that they're all capable of something much more than they'd ever envisioned. And it's really inspiring to watch that. When the scholars begin the summer, they've never been in this experience before. Many of them have never had a job, which makes sense. They're only 16, 17, 18 years of age. And so this is all new, it's all foreign. And then you throw on top of that the fact that we're placing very high demands. The bar that we hold for the scholars is high. By the end of the summer, they have made that transformation. And so now they're functioning like professional scientists. And to demonstrate that, we've got one scholar already as a co-author on a paper. And that's a huge accomplishment. Many scholars will go back to school and in many cases increase their GPAs by a full point or more. We see 100% of our high school students have matriculated into four-year programs. And what's been remarkable is how many stories at every level that we hear from high school students, undergrads, and post-bacs, where they will talk about how their friends have been inspired, how their families have been inspired, and I want to see this grow. I want to see it last forever, spread to other universities across our country, and make a major impact, changing people's lives everywhere that it goes. You know, Hopkins was founded on a mission to improve health. And in our current times, the greatest health problems actually correlate more with economic disparities than they do with really almost anything else. And so by trying to improve the socioeconomic fabric of our community, actually I think fits precisely within the Hopkins mission of trying to improve healthcare more generally. What we aspire to is to close that socioeconomic gap and help any capable scholar to be able to be a success.